everybody. Coach Austin here. Just wanted to say one thing about the video. We do have a little bit of like a cut in there because we decided to film on the pool deck. So my phone was recording and it got overheated. So it made the video stop for a second. It also has this weird glare on it. So it was one of those days I forgot my laptop and I was not able to film it on my computer like I normally do. But it is episode 12, 13? I think it's 13. 12, I wasn't there last week, and it's on Mike's Instagram page. So if you need to watch that, go look him up at Fast and Fit Mike on Instagram and say bye to Ellie. Enjoy the video.
Coaches and coffee poolside. I feel like it's a field trip today. Talking about glutes out here at the pool.
Booty.
The benefits of glutes. How to train glutes, where to start. My shirt is off. I'm getting a little bit of sun on my left shoulder.
Yeah, I was going to tell you your left shoulder is looking a little light.
Well, that's why we're out here. Anyway, thanks for the field trip. Thanks for being with us out here poolside. Guys, glutes, man. First off, did you train today?
I did 40 minutes of cardio at 5 a.m. this morning.
I have not
it's
yet.
Horrible.
Anything on the docket?
I think I might work out, yeah.
I'm doing back at noon.
I've done a little pool sesh. Pool sesh.
Pool. Not to be confused with pool.
Hey, Kevin, can you hear us okay out here? Can you hear us okay? Give me a thumbs up if you can hear us okay. Just want to make sure the sound is okay because we got a music in the background and a lot of stuff going on. So,
but?
He said yes,
but.
Sir.
It's an asset. Yeah, he said yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, we're good on sound.
We're good then.
Sound check's good. Thanks, Kevin. Where do you start when training the glutes? And kind of starting from like foundational, you know?
Yeah.
Austin, you want to take it?
Well, I mean, if you think about the glute, so like what the glute does, right? Like your glute muscle, what flexes your hip
I like
and externally
that.
Rotates. Externally rotates your femur. I think that's the bone. That's like what it's for. The two main things. So I think usually when I start with people, we start to do things that do that. You know, like example, you meet somebody on the floor. We're doing an onboarding session or something. When we start to squat, I mean, instantly what you look for, one, is people's range of motion, and two, those things. Are your knees caving in? Are they pushed out? Are your feet slightly externally rotated? And that usually comes back to people are not engaging their glutes. So that's usually what I look at from the start of somebody, just to like if I got somebody in front of me, regardless who they are.
So let's look at, yeah. Let's, like an assessment,
let's,
right?
Let's look at like an air squat or like how you sit into a chair, you know, yep. Something like that.
Yep.
That's where I would start because that's the two things that are gonna happen. That's the two.
So let's say they can't squat. Let's say they don't have, I don't know, let's say they don't have the range of motion. Okay.
Would you say because of knee or what's
I don't
the
know, maybe
issue?
Just not flexible enough, like something,
I
mean, yeah.
Yeah, I guess there's a lot of different issues, right?
Yeah.
People may not be able to get into that range of motion because of tight calves. Like for example, I had a client just recently started increasing the amount of walking that she was doing and her calves got tight. And so she was leaning forward a lot. And her feet were actually collapsing in, and I found out that she was walking a lot, and so the next like 5 days, she did a lot of tissue work, got a lot of mobility work in the ankle, and then the squat ended up improving. And so it doesn't just have to come from like
ankle mobility,
that's where you ask.
Ankle
right,
mobility
right,
is huge.
Right.
Most people can't get into it. I mean, that's why you see myself and everybody else. You know, other people either use Olympic weightlifting shoes or the heel platform is if your ankle mobility is usually crap. Most people's ankle mobility is usually not the greatest.
And my runners.
And even if you do have good ankle mobility, it's still something you can use to get in a better position. You know, a platform or lifting shoes. That's why you know we call them high heels, but that's.
I use them when we do alpha.
Yeah, I mean, you use them when you start to do things like that because I would say almost everybody, even us, right? Like Corbin said, most people don't have access to the optimal range of motion in their ankle.
Yep.
Yeah.
So there's like workarounds, right? So you said we could add Olympic lifting shoes, but we could also, let's say, okay, we're not going to wait weeks for this person to get miraculously more mobile.
Or, let's put or go buy shoes. Yeah.
Yeah, let's put something underneath your heels.
So, I mean, you could do a couple things. You can either do, like, depending on what you need to start with, right? If it needs to be more aggressive, you can do things like weight plates. You can do the little 2.5 pound plates, something just to get your heel up, you know? Like, you can even do what they call them, like, cyclist squats or sissy squats, put your heels up on a platform or something and just attempt to go to range of motion, you know.
Well, and also I think if you're trying to fire some more glutes, sometimes I think if you make it a little bit more of a hip dominant squat can help. And typically some people in a hip dominant squat might not, the range of motion is going to be a little bit different than a somewhat more knee dominant, like high bar, you know, high bar versus low bar. So low bar being more of a hip dominant, right? Where you're almost hinging at the hips to get down into a squat, right? Because that's, in my opinion, like for me, that really fires my glutes. If I really, if like my sole purpose in a squat is like, man, I really want to get my glutes. Not that doing a regular squat is not going to fire you, it absolutely will.
Right.
But elevating those heels and getting into a depth is going to really target those quads, which you should do too. Like anybody out there that's like, I just want to grill my glutes, but not my quads and hamstrings, that's silly.
So explain to me, is a limited range of motion then, is that what you're saying?
What's that?
If you're saying like some sort of...
For doing a hip dominant?
Hip dominant,
I would say if they had an issue and you really wanted that person to do some type of squat still, you know what I mean? Without, if let's say you didn't want to elevate their heels quite yet or something like that, assessing to see if how their form is in a hip dominant squat, maybe they still might not have the flexibility to, you know, do so, but they might be able to contract their glutes a little bit more using more hips. Does that make sense?
Well, explain to me the position, like a hip dominant versus non-hip dominant. That's
so hip, so starting like, so in it, when you're starting a squat, at least for me and how I coach it, is I kind of want in a normal, you know, more of a high bar squat, I want their hips and knees to go at the same time.
Okay.
Right? Does that make sense?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Whereas if I'm doing more of a hip dominant squat, I'm going to make their hips the first thing that goes.
Okay.
So it's almost like they're almost going to start a good morning.
Okay. Yep.
Does that make sense?
Yep.
And so I'm starting with my hips back almost in that pelvic tilt, right?
Yep.
And then I'm coming down, really abducting my knees out.
I got you.
Yeah.
So it's almost like a power squat.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Yeah.
I think it's funny that, you know, we're talking about glutes and now we're right up talking about squatting, so that should show you like how much it's involved in a lot of other things.
Yeah, because there are other exercises.
You think about like how do I just get my glutes, you know, that's the only thing.
But it's a good place to start.
It's a good,
and I think there's so many different variations in which you could, with a squat, whether it be a hip dominant squat or just a traditional regular you know, regular squat, whether it be back squat, front squat. I think pause squats are awesome.
Pause squats?
Awesome. For building glutes.
I've actually had people holding the bottom.
Like if you have the mobility.
Squat hold.
I struggle so much in watching, especially females that want to grow their glutes, you know, just overloading too much weight on the bar, not getting good depth, where if they just lighten it up, and this goes for anybody, not just females, but if you just lighten it up maybe 20, 30 pounds and get to good depth, stay down there in that hole for about a good 2 to 3 seconds. Yeah, it sucks. But man, you're gonna really feel those glutes by the end of that.
Yeah.
You know? Good for that first phase too. Yeah. You got somebody for like 12 to 16 weeks.
Yeah.
Get them in that first phase, pausing. It helps with awareness down the bottom.
We also talk about, I mean, the beginning too, you get a lot more time under tension too.
It increases
when you pause.
Your strength so much too, yeah. You know?
Yeah. So I think all the topics we've talked about so far, right, with your glutes, we always seem to come back to your range of motion, right? That's a big one. So if we're just trying to like grow the glutes, and like sidebar, like if you're trying to like grow muscle, is different than maybe just how we're working the glute. You know, we don't want Corbin to really sound like he's on like autopilot talking about, you know, nutrition. It's important, different video though, but like working the glutes, like how do I know that my glutes are firing or growing them, quote unquote, like being stronger.
And it's okay to feel other muscles too. Like,
absolutely.
That's one of the biggest things, you know, what we were talking about a second ago is I hear it a lot where I used to have these clients, especially again, female clients are like, you know, I just really want to grow my glutes, but I don't want to grow my quads, or I don't want my hamstrings. Right. I'm like, so you basically want to walk around looking like a chicken. That's what you're
right.
Number two, like, it's just not like, sorry, it's just, there's not a pure a glute isolation exercise where it's just going to purely work.
Right. I mean,
it's just not.
There's nothing wrong with talking about other coaches. Like, you and I watch RP Strength, like Dr. Mike all the time. He was literally talking about how you focusing too much on your, it's kind of in this realm, but too much on your form to the point of where it stops you from actually strength training. So like, to this point, like if you're so worried about getting a glute pump that you try to take everything off your quads, well, like, then you end up doing something
completely wrong
or like made up, you know, like
the firing mechanics.
Right. Like, did you feel it in your quads? Yes. Well, did you get a really good glute pump? Yes. Okay. There's nothing wrong with that. Like, you're going to get both, you know?
Yeah. You want to be balanced too.
Right.
You want to be balanced. You don't want to just have one muscle. Like, I don't want just a strong chest and a weak back. Like, that's going to only get you hurt.
Right.
I think that's a good transition to talking about injury prevention, right?
So, oh, yeah.
People that are very quad dominant, patellar tendonitis, you know, they have overdeveloped quads, and rarely have I ever heard of someone being like, well, my glutes are too much stronger than my quads.
Yeah, right. I just have too strong of a butt.
So,
yeah.
Like, working that posterior chain, it's almost like pushing to pulling. Most people need to do more pulls.
This right now, this is that moment where my phone got overheated and it cut. Now the rest of the video, it's like right up on my chest because I'm trying to keep my phone in the shade because we're in a cabana. So yeah, sorry that it looks so weird, but please enjoy.
A lot better, but you're not gonna probably push the same amount of weight.
Correct.
Which
right.
is totally fine.
Right.
You're still getting a great stimulus, you know.
And the opposite of a pre is a post exhaust, right? Where you might do a big deadlift followed by like hip bridges or walking lunges, you know, just kind of like the icing on the cake. So
right. You
got your pre-exhaust where you're stimulating the specific muscle that you want to fire, and then you got the post-exhaust where you're just exhausting, like absolutely just trying to like take it to failure, and it's maybe a little bit more stupid of a movement in the sense that it doesn't take as much skill, but it just destroys, just you're just trying to destroy it. So
right.
A good example for the quads, I put this guy through a session last week. It was a leg extension, and then we went into a leg press. So we've got the quads fired up, and then we superset with a leg extension. You could do something similar to that for the posterior chain. It could be like a lying hamstring curl into a deadlift, you know,
right.
just getting the posterior chain woke up. So we talked about mobility. We talked a little bit about where to start with an athlete and some of the limitations, right? Ankle, knee, and hip. I think just to continue to talk about like mobility, make sure you're foam rolling your quads and doing your hip flexor stretches, like your couch stretch. Mm-hmm. Because if you cannot extend your hip, Austin first talked about like the mechanics and the function of the glute muscle is to extend the hip. And if you cannot, if you don't have access to extend the hip, you will not fire it as much.
Right.
And that's why I tell all my runners, like, if you can't get that hip into extension, your hamstring is actually going to overwork. So we're getting a lot of people, a lot of my run buddies are getting hamstring issues right now. And that's because they have underdeveloped glutes, because they aren't extending their hips, which I think at the root of it is because they have tight hip flexors. So kind of get to the root of these things.
Well, you know? then you really get into the ballpark. So like when I was a strength and conditioning coach at the university, right? Women's soccer. I know. Hang on. We can talk into this one.
Is this still going?
Yeah, I restarted it. But
is that one? No, I don't know.
But we can all lean back on this one. But we talk about there were so many, the girls got injuries that had to do with their knees, you know? And it's because soccer players run a lot, same sort of thing. And we didn't do what I was in the process of doing was trying to like create things where we start to like work back up their glutes and their hamstrings to protect their knees when they were playing. That kind of stuff. Yeah. Instagram Live went down.
I'm distracted now because of my phone. I was actually just gonna pull it.
I know, that's why that's why this one's in the shade.
Yeah. Doggone it.
Hot. It's good though. It's a good topic. I hope you get back on there. So I can mention that. So they've just been looking at my name tag.
Mm. Well,
so at least they can hear it. Okay. Coaching since 1995.
It's cooled off, but I don't know that it'll save. Probably won't save now.
Oh, that
it's all right. I got this one.
Okay.
So you might have to.
I got it.
The whole thing was erased.
Well, I can't save it now. Like it.
Oh, you won't be able to get back to it.
Yeah. It's not even an option. No.
So only the people that watched it live.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. Here, let's
stay in the shade.
Right, it's everything in 5 seconds.
Yeah, look at it.
All right. So we just did an Instagram live, and we're out poolside, and my phone was basically out here. In the heat.
Same thing with the YouTube phone.
And we got a little heat warning, so we didn't get to record save all of the glute conversation. But we had a good conversation.
Most of it, part of the few you got.
Most of it will be on YouTube, though.
Austin's going to put a YouTube link up. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of good gems. Mm-hmm. We're probably going to finish it here.
Yep.
Click the link and hear the rest of the information on YouTube.
Yeah, once I post it, I'll tag these guys in it and they'll share it too. So you can kind of find it everywhere.
Yep. Cheers.
Bye.